Loch Lomond, Loch Lomond. I'm sure there are plenty of people out there who would love to correct me on that pronunciation. So this is a beginner claw hammer lesson. It's pretty straightforward. It's just a lot of bum diddying around and picking out the melody. So this is, you know, if you are looking, you know, at different versions that you might want to play along with. This one might not match exactly. There are lots of different versions out there, but while I was researching writing this arrangement, I wrote a different arrangement to this, you know, maybe a year ago or so. And I was whistling this one that I remember from my grandfather playing these like Celtic Irish fiddle records on Sunday afternoons. And I've been humming and whistling it for years since I was a kid. And when I finally went to research to make my own, for whatever reason, I had never tried to pick it out before, I couldn't really find anything that matched. So I just kept picking around until I got it right and I came up with this one. So, you know, not to say it's played wrong. There are 100 different ways to play this song. So this is, you know, it's a cool story behind it. If you aren't into stories, jump ahead a little bit. But the history of the song, I think, is cool. It's, you know, I think it was like the Battle of, I can't pronounce it. It's like Culloden or something. It's Culloden Moor or something. And it was one soldier speaking to another soldier. One soldier was sentenced to die. And he told, the other one was not going to die. He was going to be sent home to Scotland. And he was telling the other soldier, you'll take the high road and I'll take the low road referencing the path of the dead. It was believed that if you died away from your homeland, that you would take this shortcut path, your spirit would, to get back to Scotland. So that is, you'll take the high road, I'll take the low road, and I'll be in Scotland before you. Neat history to that. So, got new strings on here, so let's hope we stay in tune. Let's get to the tab. Lessons and tabs are always going to be free to you. There's a tip jar, should you feel so inclined. I feel like I say the same thing all the time. I don't want to seem like I have a catchphrase, but that's not really what's important. What's important is playing some better music. Pick it some better tunes. There, I said it. So let's check it out. We're start. The only chords you're going to deal with in this arrangement are G, we have a C, we have an E minor, and we have a two-fingered D. Those are all listed at the bottom of the tab as well. I should mention the tab is also in the video description. So, we're gonna start off G portion. Open, two, first bum to the G, open, you know, on the G note. So, we're on the D string, two, open, two, bum to the. Then you're going to move up to the G string and do pretty much the same thing, only your bum diddy is going to start on the B. So you, instead of going, now we're going. So far we have. Now we're going to come right back down. Just two notes. And then you're going to switch to your C and hit your open G. Turn back to G. So far we have. So that's, you know, we've done G, C, and then the first bum diddy of the second G. So now we're going kind of similar to what we did before. Now we're going to go open, open, so open B, then open D, C. So you're going to hit your second fret. Now the first fret on your C chord, so you're just holding this position. Then we're going to jump to D, take it from the top so you can see where we're at. We're now on the second line of the tab, so. That is our first whole line. So it sounds like this, once with the vocal, or once by itself, and then once with the vocal. So check it out. To the second part where it's partitioned here. So this is the me and my true love will never meet again. So it's E minor. You're just gonna hit the second fret on your high D. Two open G bum diddy on the B, starting on the B. So. So that is E minor, G, now we're going to go back up B, D, and then this little, if you're a beginner, this will give you a little push. It just goes like this, a little walk down lick, like this, the 1-0-2-0 to the C chord. So we're going to go C bum diddy, goes like this again. Let's take that from E minor. Once more, real slow. Now you're going to do a very quick turnaround to a D after this. And back into G. It's literally just a. So. So after that descending lick. It sounds like if you're singing along to the song, it sounds like this, me and my true love will never meet again on the bond. So, me and my true love will never meet again on the, that's the on the. Me and my true love will never meet again on the bond. Now we're going to go back to the G. So, where are we? Never meet again on the on, not the G, on, I won't sing. C, D again. That's the end. Let's take it from the descending lick. No, I won't do the fancy hit wrong. D, G, C, D. So the whole second part should sound like this. Time slowly. C, G, C, D, E minor, G, C, D, G. So that's it. Have some fun with this one. It's a great tune to sing. It's just one of my favorite songs ever. So until next time, thanks for watching.